This is what we stopped last class, correct? So we have two pills. So we go and find the ice factor online, and then we can look box factor for the first cube, cube one, and then we put ice factor for. demo for Practical07. Here. So with this one, you can do your exercise question. Therefore, practical exercise 7. So your practical exercise, I will check until practical exercise 7. Okay? So there are 4 questions here. Okay, question 1. And you have to take your pyramid. Try to texture your pyramid. Okay, you already have your pyramid. You just have to find a texture. Any textures. Okay, here is the bricks textures. You will accept any texture. I didn't ask you to show me a texture pyramid. So in your demo code, if we do the mapping, okay, to the texture, ST, and your fourth texture. Okay, your fourth texture is a 2D.
One mark for the model completeness. Okay.
It doesn't mean no crash. Okay, brake detectors, one mark rotation, and all exists. You really have to rotate the pyramid. Okay, one mark. Okay, for number two, we already have the first one already done, this one. Okay, you also have actually second one, but it's separate cube. Okay, now your miss want you to have a same cube. Okay, but you need to switch texture, okay, change texture. Okay, the same cube from the box texture or the wood texture here. Okay, able to switch three textures. Okay, here is wood, metal and brick texture. Okay, any three textures. Okay, not necessary to be wood, metal or bricks. Any three, you just have to show me you can change three textures. Okay, for the same box or the same cube. Okay, so use the key, interactive part. Okay, use the key to change texture. Okay, means here lah, you use it else. Okay, the demo here, like this one. Okay, load the file, so you use it else lah, use the key. So texture 1, texture 2, texture 3, use the key to switch the texture. Okay, go and find three textures. Okay, switch among the three textures, three marks. Okay, completeness 1 mark, okay, no crash, rotation all axis 1 mark, this one 5 marks. Okay, 5 marks. Okay, this one you can finish in the class, can do faster. So now look at your question 3 and 4. Question 3 and 4 is the sphere and cylinder. Okay, that one is in your PowerPoint slides. Okay, in your practice folder, you see the PowerPoint slides. Practical exercise 7, open the PowerPoint slides. Okay, this is now question 1 and 2 is 4 and 5 marks, 9 marks there. Okay, another 16 marks is here. Okay, two more questions. Okay, question 3 is to texture your ice cream. Okay, your ice cream is GRU objects, quadrate objects, sphere and cylinder. Okay, so now we'll see how we're going to texture sphere and cylinder. Okay, let's do this first. Okay, very simple, very easy. Okay, this one cute, this one really is cute. Turn on display. Okay, don't want the cube, comment off the cube. Okay, change to sphere. Let's draw sphere. Okay, call a draw sphere. But draw sphere function or not? Ada. Okay, don't have draw sphere. If you have, then you can just call a draw sphere. Don't have, then go and take from your previous exercise. This one don't have draw sphere function. Let your miss go take first from practical 4, practical 5. Draw sphere functions from your previous code so that in your display here, change your Q1, you can comment off. Okay, draw sphere. Okay, let's say draw the word 5. Craft the sphere. Change the sphere to fill, don't want wireframe, just cannot see the texture. No stuff. Okay, then we'll fill sphere so that you can see. Okay, box two also, I don't want the box. So if you haven't do mapping, then you only see the texture color, this is the box texture color. Okay? So the to do sphere and the cylinder mapping, your step 3, step 4, all these things are same. You still use factor function. Okay, so just the mapping part. Okay, for cube, you map one by one your texture coordinate to your vertex. Okay, but GLU, because you draw your sphere and cylinder using GLU library, okay, you don't have GL vertex, so you cannot map to each of your vertex. So in order to do the spherical and the cylindrical mapping, so very simple, just call this function GLU quadratic texture. Okay, then pass in your quadratic object pointers and then set your boolean here to true. Okay, one line only to map. Okay, so we just copy this. Okay, put it at your draw sphere function. Go to your draw sphere function. Then before your GLU sphere. Okay, you put the quadratic texture. Okay, so this one first function is your quadratic object, pointer, sphere. Okay, boolean texture here, set it to true. Same thing. Okay, you also take the draw cylinder function.